Yes. Hello and welcome. My name is Amy Bowser Tennant, the genealogy reporter, and I'm going to show you a search technique to locate missing children in a family tree. And these missing children may be missing because perhaps they were born and died in between census years, or perhaps a daughter was born after 1880 census, but she married prior to the 1900 census being taken. And so in both of these cases, these children will not appear with their families in a census. And sometimes they fall between the cracks and we need to find them. And I'm going to use FamilySearch to do this technique because FamilySearch.org is free and available to anyone. First, I would log in here and an account at FamilySearch is free, so go ahead and feel free to do that. And then we would normally click on Search, Records, and we would come to this page. Now this is our search page, and generally speaking, we would type in the individual that we are looking for by first and last name, and perhaps a birthplace and year, and search. But in this case, the person is missing, or we don't even know that they exist, so we have no first name to look them up by. So we're going to try a little bit different parameters. This time we're going to choose only to search by last name, and we're going to do a birthplace. And then we're going to choose parents, and we're going to talk a little bit about how to search by parents' names. But I've already done an example, so I'm going to pop over here. And my parameters were as follows. I did a last name of Cole, a birthplace as Lee, Virginia. I scrolled down, remember, and I had opened up the parents section and did a search by the father's name. I want to say a little something here. And then by death place first. And that's because sometimes an individual will appear in the birthplace, or I'm sorry, a birth record, and not in the death records. And so if you're looking only in death records, you might miss a child who appears in the birth records. Also, for the parent criteria down here, I have found that I can search by just the father, just the mother, both the father and mother, or even possibly just by the last name of the father and the last maiden name of the mother. So each time I get a little bit different results by changing these parameters. In this case, I knew that Jacob Cole had married Margaret Mitchell. I know that he had been married before, but I didn't believe that they had had any children. So I did this search for Jacob Cole as the father of any Cole child born in Lee County, Virginia. And I came up with these four hits that were really important. Here is Elizabeth. Elizabeth was born to Jacob Cole and Kitsy Cole. And Kitsy was Jacob's first wife. Like I said, I did not know that they had had children before Kitsy passed away. Notice Elizabeth was born in October of 1880. That means she did not appear on the 1880 census with her family. And she actually ended up marrying prior to the 1900 census. So she went missing for an entire decade before we located her. Next, we have John Cole. And John was also born to Jacob and Kitsy, or Keziah. And I didn't know about him either. And that's because he was born in 1883, so after the 1880 census. And by 1900, he had already passed. He passed away when he was just 3 years old. And so in this way, we were able to find two children that would have otherwise gone unnoticed. Let's take a look here as well. Here we have a search for, again, the last name of Cole. And in this case, we've chosen the word any place. Instead of birth and deaths, we've done any place and chose Harlan County, Kentucky. Scroll down. And like I mentioned before, I did this search with the parameters of the father's last name only and the mother's last name or maiden name only. I found marriage records that popped up. This is my grandfather's marriage record. But as I scrolled down, I noticed these two children here, two daughters, Martha Cole and Charity Cole. Now, I knew Martha. My great aunt Martha was one of their children, but I did not know about Charity. And Charity had been born in 1913. I have never found a death record for her, but she did not appear in the 1920 census. And I knew from our family history, Joni and her husband had had a daughter that passed away as a child. And so she had gone, she was not in the death records. She was here in the Kentucky Vital Record Index, which was actually a record. So give this a try. Look for those missing children by using a parent search with these parameters, and hopefully you will find some missing persons that need to be reunited with their family. I hope you've enjoyed this topic and can put it to great use. Please subscribe to the Genealogy Reporter. Follow us on Facebook, here on YouTube, Twitter, and on the blog www.genealogyreporter.com. Thanks. Bye-bye.